before I start talking about demystifying brand building experience, let me demystify a phenomena that's happening right here in this room. When I walked in, I was hit by high levels of energy and excitement in this room, and that's when I realized that, you know, I am in the midst of marketing gurus and media gurus, so I'm really glad to be here this afternoon. Thank you, Anurag ji, and Pitch, as well as all the co-sponsors who have given me this opportunity to share some ideas with you on the X factor in building brands. So let's get down to demystifying brand building experiences. You know, as you know, Titan has, and Vinita referred to it, that we have a portfolio of brands, each of them catering to different consumer segments and have been built over years. So what I'm going to share with you are stories of our brands which cater to different consumer segments. It's about a two-hour presentation, so just hang on. You know, when we, every day we come across so many brands in our lives, from morning to evening. And there are occasions when our hearts skip a beat. Our hearts skip a beat when we see a shot like this. Now, this is not a spaceship, we know that. It's not an orange, it's Apple. It's the iPhone. You walk into a store and you are greeted by somebody, your heart skip a beat. These are experiences which are very different. You go and sit down in a restaurant, you don't feel like eating the food because it looks so delicious and looks so pretty, untouched, and you feel so good about it. Every day we are on some helpline or the other, and invariably they refuse to help you. But the moment you come across a conversation that you have which is truly helpful, it's quite an elevating experience. So what is this X factor? And what does X stand for, which is what I'm going to talk about. The X factor is the whole journey of these encounters that we have with a brand over a period of time. If all these encounters are positive and engaging, that is when you know, you'd start developing bond with a brand. People used to talk about brand loyalty. Very few people talk about brand loyalty these days. People talk about brand investment. There's, I think, enough written and said about how long it takes brands to be built. It takes 5 minutes for it to be destroyed if your reputation, if something goes wrong. Vinita spoke about being a content creator. But in today's world, if you know, they say if content is king, then engagement is queen. And in a house, you know, who's the boss of the house? So it's the queen that rules the house. So engagement is something which is so very critical today. And that's what I'm going to share and talk about. So brand experience, the X in my X factor stands for brand experience. And let me share some of these stories with you. We've done a lot of work, you know, on the consumer journey right from they get exposed to a brand to the final purchase and beyond. And this varies at different price points. This journey varies from brand to brand because we're talking of different age groups. And a consumer journey, if you see, is not linear. It's neither static at any stage. It is iterative, complex, and dynamic. Based on the research that we've done, we've come across five stages, so to say, of a consumer journey. The first, of course, is the one which I'm not going to talk about, which are consumers who are not in the market, they are non-intenders. But look at this slide. It's supposed to be complicated. You're not supposed to read it. The whole idea is to convey to you that the whole journey is very, very complicated. So don't try and read it. Let me just briefly explain to you the four stages that I'm talking about are creating desire for a brand, the whole discovery process in today's world and how it takes place, the moment of truth, which is the actual purchase, and finally, the post-buying experience. Just for a summary of the slide, all the points above, the touch points, are digital touch points and all the points below are physical touch points. The ones which are solid blocks are the ones which can be managed, the other ones cannot be managed. Okay. Now, this is the only boring slide in my entire presentation. So let's move on to some excitement. This is just to tell you the whole story, and I promise not to create such a or talk about such a complicated slide again. Desire. In today's world, this is the stage where consumers haven't yet decided on the product, haven't certainly homed in on the brand. They're just getting exposed to a category. They have not even decided that this is the category they want, this is the product they want, and this is the brand they want. And therefore, it is the brand's objective to create intrigue and desire. And the key is differentiation, as it says here. I'm going to talk about two case studies from Titan, which talk about desire and how we created desire. Anuragji spoke about, I don't know whether it's presentation, but he was telling me that he's tracking his steps these days, he's wearing a smartwatch. We made our entry into smartwatches 3 years back. And as Titan always does, we wanted to be different from the rest of the world. We didn't want it to be one more gadget on your wrist. Consumers have evolved quite a bit. India is still at its nascent stage, but if you look at Europe, consumers today are saying, I want a good-looking watch and I want it to be smart. The other thing they are saying is that I don't really need so many features. I mean, in a mobile phone, if you say the latest mobile phone that you buy, you have tons of features, but how many do you finally use? So we did research to find out what do consumers look for in a smartwatch. The two biggest use cases were notifications and activity tracking, which is the number of steps you count. These were the two basic things. So we said we will create a watch which is good looking, which is not necessarily digital but smart, but takes care of the basic features that consumers are looking for. And that's how we announced our entry into smartwatches 3 years back. We tied up with HP. As you know, Titan is known for its design capabilities, expertise in watches, as well as a consumer-centric approach in everything that we do. And needless to say, HP stands for technology and global credentials. So we created this watch, which was first a good-looking watch and then a smartwatch. The other thing about smartwatches today, digital smartwatches, is once the battery runs out, it's like a round black disc on your wrist. Whereas this will continue to look like and function like a good-looking watch. So it was about creating intrigue, and how did we do that? How did we create desire for this product? Just 5-6 days before the launch of this brand, which we call Juxt, a sub-brand, leaks went out into the market on social media. A lot of tech bloggers wrote about it. Somebody said, I came across this sketch or this product while in a shoot in a studio. And 3 days down the line, this is the teaser video that went out, without sharing much about the product. The story was about smart is now stunning. Now let's come to advertising, which is also creating desire and which we did only online without getting into the standard mass media. Typically, when you want to advertise a smartwatch, you would start talking of features, you would do a whole lot of things, but we did it very differently. We took three celebrities to create basically desire that I'm talking about of this product. And this is the ad that was run on social media as a build-up to the launch.
Hello.
That's Pritam.
क्या खा रहा
है? Sandwich.
एक मिनट. तू अपने ही घर में अपने ही गाने सुनता है?
कबीर भी तो अपने फिल्म देखता है घर पे.
अच्छा वैसे तेरा डाइट कैसा चल रहा है?
मस्त एकदम.
वो तो दिख रहा है.
जॉगिंग तो किया था?
नहीं मुझे शौक है जिम क्लोज पहन के घर में घूमने का. ऑफ कोर्स किया था 5 किलोमीटर वॉक किया.
अच्छा एक मिनट. लेकिन प्रीतम तेरा एक्टिविटी ट्रैकर तो जस्ट 20 स्टेप्स दिखा रहा है।
थैंक यू। Couldn't you just be stunning? कल से पक्का।
Let me move on to the next story of building desire. And this is another story of creation of a watch which is very unlike a normal watch. As some of you may know, we have a sub-brand called Octane which is in the sporty space. And we have a sub-brand within Octane which we launched which was called Squadron, which was inspired from fighter jets. So each watch, we had a portfolio of four watches and each watch was inspired from some part of a fighter jet. And each watch had a name, so this one was called Hawker, this one was called Scouter. You can see the, you know, the on the right side, the whole construction that you see, that whole structure comes out, it's inspired from the control stick of a fighter jet. You know, the whole theme that you can see a plane there as part of the second hand. And all watches had a story to tell. This was the Falcon. And this was the ad that went online to create desire for this particular product.
Made of speed. Made of man's love for machine. Introducing Squadron by Titan Octane. Inspired by fighter jets. Hawker. Thunderbolt. Falcon. Scouter. Automatic movement. Complex case construction. Up to 10 ATM water resistance in solid black and bold yellow. Feel the supersonic speed. Squadron by Titan Octane.
Let's move on to the discovery process. Now, stage of this whole consumer journey. This is the stage where consumers start, looking into the brand, getting to learn a little bit, go online. You know, there's this whole bit about ropes and all of that, which you research online, then you go and buy in a store, get to know more about the product. And this is that stage where it's very important for the brand to create personal relevance as well as brand preference that anyway is built over a period of time. This is the story of Raga. Raga, as you know, is a brand created for women, has a very strong loyal base of customers. They wait for every Diwali to wait for the latest collection that comes out and buy every Diwali. It has its own unique design language, as we all know. Realized that there was a certain set of consumers and women who were buying Raga. The new age consumer as well as the younger girls or the younger women were not buying Raga. So it was about how do we make this brand Raga relevant to the younger audience and the new age consumer. And that is when we did something very different. Typically, you would go to a watch designer. We went to an apparel designer, Masaba, who is an apparel designer, as you know, and is very, very active on social media, has a lot of following on social media, has her own signature design, which is very bold, very different. People said, you are nuts. You know, how do you expect somebody like Masaba to design watches? She's never done it in her life. And this is what two samples of what she created, her unique design language. And Raga had to be discovered, you know, this is the discovery stage that I'm talking about. Every time the consumer went looking for fashion online, it was Raga that would pop up, the Masaba line from Raga. It was a completely digital first approach and it worked very well. This is about the creation.
Let's talk. Who says tradition can't be playful? Who says old can't be new? Who says beautiful can't be fierce? And who says heritage can't be cool? Who says design shouldn't defy reality? Who says black and white isn't colorful? Who says stars are born, not made? Who says culturally rooted can't be modern? Who says quirky can't be elegant? Who says bold can't be subtle? Who says flaws are mistakes? Who says in your face lacks grace? Who says you can't make time stand still? And for those who say you can't travel back in time, I have reimagined time.
We also used Bollywood influencers. We all know influencers play a key role. Gone are the days of brand ambassadors that we used to talk about. And this is what we did in that case. My second story is about, again, a different segment, which is the youth of today. As you know, we have a brand called Fast Track, which targets the youth. Over a period of time, we realized that youth had stopped wearing watches. And Fast Track, as a brand, had slowed down. All the money that the youth have today, they want to spend on upgrading their mobile phones, and watches is not on their mind at all. We realized also that they had started wearing fitness bands. So we said, we are not only in watches, why can't we have our own fitness bands? Because that's now the cool tech accessory, as they say, and there are over 100 brands today. But here again, when we entered, it was a very different approach that we used to ensure that we are prominent in the whole discovery process. The strategy was to move away from the serious code that typically a smart band has. Take on the Fast Track property that it has built over a period of time, which is about being edgy, about being irreverent, being unpredictable and cool. A lot of A-plus content on e-commerce was used for this, and it was very, very successful. A reflection of that, we had a lot of ads which were on. You went on YouTube and generated lots of walk-ins to our stores. I love this ad, which is again very different.
Hey, burnt enough for the day?
No, I need to burn 350 calories more.
I can help.
Introducing Fast Track Reflex with Calorie Tracker.
Titan is not known to be a tech company. I mean, this was about our first entry into smart bands, and we call it Reflex from Fast Track. But a few months back, we launched, it's very difficult to imagine that a company like ours would take that step. We launched, some of you may know, the slimmest slimmest fitness band with a display in the world, and the first gesture control band in the world. So this band, we call it Reflex Wave, as in W-A-V. With various gestures, you can control different things. So when if you are, let's say, in a gym and you are, you're listening to a song, you want to increase the volume, you just do a gesture, it goes to either the next song or the volume goes up. When I'm making a presentation, I could have probably worn it today. You want to move to the next slide, you just do a gesture, it goes to the next slide. You do it reverse, it goes to the previous slide. It is the first gesture control band in the world, and it's done very well. Okay, now the moment of truth, which is the purchase stage in the whole cycle. Here again, it has to be very, very different. And I'll tell you what we have done. As you know, we have a business called the eyewear business, and we have a chain of stores called Titan Eye Plus. We launched this product there in an eyewear purchase decision. There's a lot of interaction with the with the whole the person, the salesperson behind the counter. In fact, we call them eyewear consultants. This program which we launched, which is a customer delight program, because if you are offering a solution, you're not just selling a product. This program called the Make Heartbeat program is today a benchmark. It has won many awards, not just in India, but globally. And I'll just tell you how we kind of launched this program and what and the spirit of this whole program, how our eyewear consultants that I'm talking about treat their customers is truly captured in this video that you'll see here.
Thank you.
Ma?
Good morning.
Morning.
Baby Vandit, it's very heavy. I need something which is very light and simple.
No worries. We have a lot of varieties here. No. I'll get it. Try these again.
This is nice.
When was the last time you got your eyes tested?
About 2 years ago.
Why don't you try these? There were some small scratches, but we fixed them.
This is nice. How did you do this?
Come, why don't you get your eyes tested? This way. Power hasn't changed at all. Ah, coffee. The filter coffee here is very nice. You must try. Without sugar?
What about this? Polycarbonate lens?
Since you've chosen a full frame, polycarbonate is not needed. Plastic lenses are more than enough. And they cost lesser. It'll be delivered home in 3 days. Thank you, ma. Sorry. Thank you, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you very much, Satish. God bless you.
Treat every customer like they are someone special. Make hearts beat. Titan Eye Plus.
So that was about treating a customer like you treat your mother, and the we get thousands of delight stories from customers, and that I think is the biggest gratification. Even our sales force, people in the stores, incentives and all don't work. They just look at how many delight stories they are getting from customers, and that is what keeps them going. Now moving on to the post-buy experience of the brand, I'm going back to our earlier brand called Fast Track for Youth, how we engage with the youth, and how we connect with them post-purchase, and whether they purchase or not is not important, but being connected with them as a brand is what is critical.